Today, we're talking about the Lamb. We are talking about the Lamb. And today, I have a special story because, as Lauren told us, there's many different ways to tell about creation. And today, I'm going to tell the story from the Native American side because, for the Native American, the land is us and we are the Lamb. We are one together. And there are three words that the Native spirituality holds up. It's honor, love, and respect for our Mother Earth. We are part of everything, and everything is part of us. So we are in this dirt. Can you imagine? We are in it. We're a part of this dirt right here. We are in it, and it is in us. Those things that we can see, what kind of things can we see in nature? What can we see? What do we see outside? Flowers. What else? Dirt. What else?
Birds.
Trees. Birds. Henry? What else?
Wind.
We can't really see the wind, but we can see what the wind blows. So that leads me to, I was going to say, we are connected with those things that we can see and we cannot see. Like the air around us, we can't see that, but we are connected to that. And Mother Earth is a great rhythm of life, from life to birth to growth to decay to the moon and the stars, all of that working together. So today I'm going to tell a story that comes from the Native American spirituality about how the land was recreated. The Great Spirit brought the world into being. There came some very long ago where animals lived only in deep water and there was no land. And they were tired of swimming and being wet. They were weary of that. They wanted to bring up some mud from the bottom of the earth and bring it up and create some land. So the Great Spirit brought together four animals, those that he thought could live under the water for a long time. He recruited them to go down and pick up that water, that mud from the bottom of the where the water was. Now first he called for the loon. He sent the loon down, and the loon went down, couldn't hold the breath long enough and could not bring up any mud, and came back up. Next, he sent down the baton, the otter. The otter went down with its strong webbed feet, but came back up without any mud. Third, he sent down the kapaw. Who knows what that is? The beaver. Third, he sent down the beaver. With his long, flat tail, he thought for sure the beaver would be able to hold his breath long enough to get down there and pull up some mud. But you think the beaver did it? The beaver did not do it. Finally, he sent down the fourth animal, the kiah, the turtle. The turtle went down under the water for so long that everyone was sure he had drowned. Then, with his flash, the turtle broke the water surface, and mud filled his feet, his claws, under his shell on the front, under his shell on the back. He had brought up a piece of mud. Singing, the Great Spirit shaped the mud into his hands and spread it onto the turtle's back. He shook, as you can see, he shook some eagle feathers over that mound of mud. And as he mounted that up onto the turtle's back, and the turtle raised his back, the land began to grow on his back. And all was good. And the Great Spirit reminded them, honor, love, and respect. Each of us in creation and the Mother Earth. And little Donald felt very badly that she couldn't be here today because she knows all about the turtle. And maybe some of you have seen this picture. She actually has a turtle on her arm tattooed, because she knows of the Great Spirit of the turtle. So she wished she could be here today. Now, not only are we connected to Mother Earth, we are also all connected to each other. So this morning we are all
in the front row.
Together. Amen.